Alright, in this video I want to talk about solving some trigonometric equations, and the equations we're going to see are going to be relatively, not too bad, but the idea is typically you're going to have, more complicated equations that eventually reduce to, finding solutions to these types of equations. So, starting here with the basics, so suppose we want to find all solutions to sine x equals root 3 over 2. Well, this is one of these things, this is kind of one of these values I think you just have to have memorized. So it goes back to the unit circle. And recall that on the unit circle, at the angle pi over 3 radians, the x coordinate's 1/2, but the y coordinate is root 3 over 2. So definitely we can say one of our solutions here is going to be x equals pi over 3. Now, there's other places on the unit circle where certainly where sine equals root 3 over 2. Likewise, if we go over to the angle 2 pi over 3, there's my bad circle. So now at the angle 2 pi over 3, the x-coordinate is now going to be negative 1/2, but the y-coordinate, again, is still root 3 over 2. So 2 pi over 3 is going to be another solution. So x equals 2 pi over 3. And now, certainly those aren't the only solutions. Those would be the only solutions between 0 and 2 pi, but we're not given any restrictions here really on the interval for x. So to me the idea is, again, since I'm at pi over 3, I can either add or subtract multiples of 2 pi. That'll put me at the same equivalent place on the unit circle. So we can simply add multiples of 2 pi by saying plus 2 pi times n, where n is an integer. And we'll have to do the same thing for our other solution, 2 pi over 3, because again, if you add or subtract multiples of 2 pi, it's going to put you back at that same equivalent angle. So the other solutions would simply be x equals 2 pi over 3, plus 2 pi times n. Again, n is an integer.